Hi guys, in this video I will discuss about the face presentation. So face presentation is a rare variety of cephalic presentation, means face presentation occurs very rarely. So the presenting part in the face presentation is face. Next is attitude. So attitude of the limbs is well flexed. So here I write flexion of limbs. Next is spine. So the spine shows the extension like this. You can see here, this is a vertex presentation. Here the spinal cord shows flexion, while in the case of face presentation the spinal cord shows extension. Next is the head. Head is fully extended so that the occiput lies in contact with the back. So here I write. Head is completely extended so that it lies in contact with back. Next is denominator in the face presentation. Denominator is a part which touches the pelvic floor first. So in the face presentation, the part which touches the pelvic floor first is mentum or chin. Mentum, which is also known as chin. Next is positions in the face presentation. So there are 6 positions in the face presentation. In the first position, this is a symphysis pubis, and posteriorly this is a sacrum. This is right side and this is left side. So when the chin or the mentum lies in contact with the left iliopubic eminence, this is iliopubic eminence, that position is known as left mento anterior. In the next position, when the chin or the mentum lies in relation to the right iliopubic eminence, then this position is known as right mento anterior. In the third position, when the chin lies in relation or lies in contact with right ischial spines, then this position is known as right mento lateral. In the fourth position, when the mentum or the chin lies in relation to the right sacroiliac joint, then this position is known as right mento posterior. In the fifth position, if the mentum or the chin lies in relation to the sacroiliac joint at the left side, then this position is known as left mento posterior. In the sixth and the last position, when the mentum or the chin lies in relation to the left ischial spines, so this position is known as left mento lateral. So among these six positions, left mento anterior is the common position. Next is the incidence of face presentation. Incidence means the frequency or the chances of face presentation, which is actually very less. That is 1 in 500 births. Among 500 births, there is only one who bonds with the face presentation. And it is very much common in the multiparous woman, that is 70%. Multiparous women are those who are pregnant for more than one time. And it is common among multiparous women because the muscles of the abdomen is already very much relaxed, which favors the face presentation. Next one is etiology or the causes of face presentation. It is divided into two, that is maternal causes or the fetal causes. So under the maternal causes, first one is multiparity with pendulous abdomen. Again the same thing, multiparity or the multiparous woman with pendulous abdomen. Pendulous abdomen means the loose muscles of the abdomen hanging, as due to the continuous pregnancies or due to the pregnancy more than one time, the muscles of abdominal wall is relaxed and loosened, because of which the abdomen start hanging. That is known as pendulous abdomen, which favors the face presentation. Next is lateral obliquity of the uterus. Lateral obliquity of the uterus means when the uterus rotates on its long axis towards the right side, which favors the face presentation. That is here in this diagram. The uterus is rotated towards the right side on its long axis. This is also known as dextrorotation. Like here you can see the uterus, this is a long axis of the uterus, and the uterus rotates on its long axis towards the right side or towards lateral sides. That is known as dextrorotation. So this dextrorotation or the lateral obliquity of the uterus favors the face presentation. Next is contracted pelvis. So there is a 40% chances that in face presentation, the cause behind the face presentation is contracted pelvis. In the 40% cases, there is a chances that the cause behind the face presentation is contracted pelvis. Next is flat pelvis. Flat pelvis is also known as platyploid pelvis. As we know that there are four types of pelvis, that is gynecoid, which is a normal pelvis, android, anthropoid, and platyploid. And the flat type pelvis is platyploid, which favors the face presentation. Next is the pelvic tumors. On the other hand side, in the cases of fetal cause, there are 15% chances, that is the cause behind the face presentation, is congenital malformation. So the common one is anencephaly. In the maternal cause, the common one is multiparity with pendulous abdomen plus the contracted pelvis. And in congenital malformation, the common cause is anencephaly. This is a congenital malformation in which the brain and the skull bones are malformed. Like you can see in this diagram, this is a normal where the brain and the skull bones are properly formed. This is an anencephaly case in which the brain and the skull bones are malformed. In this case, there are more chances of face presentation because only face appears to be normal. So there are more chances of face presentation in the cases of anencephaly. Next one is congenital goiter. Goiter occurs due to the deficiency of iodine, in which the neck of the fetus swelled. Next is dolichocephalic head. Dolichocephalic head, here is a diagram. This is a diagram of dolichocephalic head. in which the anterior posterior, this is the anterior posterior diameter, which is actually much more than the normal one. So it favors the face presentation. How it favors the face presentation? Like the presenting diameter of the fetus should be less so that it can easily pass through the birth canal. So here the anterior posterior diameter is much more larger, so it favors the face presentation so that the lesser presenting diameter should easily pass through the birth canal. Next is twist of cord, several turns around the neck when the umbilical cord is twisted around the neck. In that condition, face presentation occurs. So these are the etiology or the causes of face presentation. Next is the mechanism of face presentation. So the main steps or the main movements in the face presentation is same as that of the vertex presentation with the occipito anterior position, which is a normal position, except few things. Like normally the engagement occurs with the flexion like this here. Normally the engagement occurs with the flexion, like head moves like this, so that the occiput touches the pelvic floor first, as occiput is a presenting part or denominator. While in the case of face presentation, engagement occurs by extension like this, so that the chin touches the pelvic floor first. So with the descent, due to the uterine contractions, extension occurs, that is the occiput lies in contact with the back, so that the chin touches the pelvic floor first. So in the face presentation, extension occurs, while normally flexion. Next is delivery of the head by extension. Normally the delivery of the head occurs by extension like this. First one is occiput bonds, then vertex, then brow, and then face, like this. But in this case, first one is chin is born, then nose, then brow, vertex, and then occiput. So here the delivery of head occurs by extension normally, but in the face presentation, the delivery of head occurs by flexion. So this is the difference. All other steps are same as that of the normal position. So first one is engagement when the presenting part enter into the pelvic brim. So the engaging diameter is oblique diameter. Engaging diameter is, that is the diameter of engagement is oblique, which is submentobrachmatic, that is 9.5 centimeter in a fully extended head. So this is a submentobrachmatic diameter, that is from the point where the chin and the neck meets, this to the mid of the anterior fontanel, that is 9.5 centimeter. So in this diagram, this is a symphysis pubis, this is a sacrum, and this is a mentum of the fetus or the chin. And this is glabella. So it is glabella. The midpoint between the eyebrows, that is known as glabella. So this position, when the mentum lies in contact with the right iliopubic eminence, then this position is known as right mento anterior. In the face presentation, the engagement delays. Why it delays? Because the area or the space between the mentum and the biparietal plane is 7 cm. So here I write distance between the mentum and the biparietal plane is 7 cm. Because of this 7 cm distance, the engagement delays, that is, the presenting parts enter into the pelvic brim delays. Like in this diagram, this is a biparietal plane. So with the onset of contractions, the extension occurs so that the chin enters the pelvic brim first. So this diameter from the biparietal plane till the mentum is 7 cm, like here. The biparietal plane goes upward so that the chin enters the pelvic brim first. So if the presenting part enters into the pelvic brim, then the engagement occurs. So to cover this huge distance, 7 cm, it takes time. So that's why the engagement delays. Next is internal rotation of mentum. So after engagement, then there is an internal rotation in which the mentum rotates 1/8 of the circle to lie behind the symphysis pubis. So here I write chin or mentum rotates 1/8 of the circle and lies behind the symphysis pubis. So after internal rotation, this comes in the anterior posterior diameter, that is the mentum lies behind the symphysis pubis. Next is crowning. In the crowning, sub mento vertical diameter stretches the vulval outlet. Submento vertical diameter, which is 11.5 cm. In this diagram, you can see the submento vertical diameter. Submento vertical starts from this point where the chin and the neck meets till the highest point of the vertex, that is 11.5 cm. So after crowning, next step is delivery of head by flexion. When the submento vertical diameter stretches the vulval outlet, then there is a delivery of head by the flexion. So first of all, the chin is pawn. Next, nose. Next, brow. Then vertex. And at last, occiput is born. You can see in this diagram, in the face presentation, firstly chin is pawn, then nose, then brow, and then vertex, and then occiput. So the delivery of head occurs by flexion. Flexion means when the head is born, the distance between the chin and the chest is decreasing. So that's why this is known as delivery of head by flexion, which is opposite in the case of normal presentation, in the vertex presentation with the occipital anterior position. So next is restitution. After the delivery of head by the flexion, next is restitution. In this, the chin rotates back by 1/8 of the circle, or the chin rotates opposite to the internal rotation. Like here, internal rotation occurs when the mentum comes behind the symphysis pubis. Chin rotates 1/8 of the circle, and now in the restitution, when the head is born, the mentum rotates back opposite to the internal rotation by rotating 1/8 of the circle. Next is internal rotation of shoulders and the external rotation of head. So in the internal rotation of shoulders, the shoulders come in anterior posterior diameter, while the head, in the case of head, after restitution, the chin comes at the iliopubic eminence and it moves more 1/8 of the circle in the case of external rotation of head. So the head is externally rotated 1/8 of the circle more, so that when the whole body lies in anterior posterior diameter and the head or the faces towards the, in the case of right mento anterior, faces towards the right thigh. So here I write, head externally moves 1/8 of the circle more, so that the face of the fetus faces towards the right thigh. So after the internal rotation of shoulders and the external rotation of the head, the whole body bonds with the lateral flexion. I thought you might not be clear with this point, so I draw this diagram. So in this, after restitution, when the chin rotates back by 1/8 of the circle and comes at this point, that is at right iliopubic eminence, and in the fifth point, when there is internal rotation of shoulders and the external rotation of head, in this the head is again rotate 1/8 of the circle, so to lie like this, so that the fetus faces towards the right thigh of the mother, in the cases of right mento anterior position, which I discussed. And at last, with the lateral flexion, the rest of the body is also born. Next is the management of face presentation. So first of all, we should have to do the assessment, assess the fetal and maternal condition. If there is a contracted pelvis, or if there is a big baby, and the complications associated with the pregnancy, for example, preeclampsia, in that case, immediate cesarean section should be done. On the other hand side, if there is no any complications, then there is two conditions. First one is mento anterior position. Second is mento posterior position. Mento anterior position we already discussed in the mechanism of face presentation. That was right mento anterior position. In this, during the internal rotation of chin only have to move 1/8 of the circle. While in the posterior positions, this is the right mento posterior position, where the chin lies at right sacroiliac joint, right mento posterior. So in the posterior positions, chin has to move 3/8 of the circle. So this is a risky position, because sometimes arrest may occur or there is a mal rotation, or in few cases there is no rotation. So in the mento anterior position, during the first stage, assess for the spontaneous dilatation. We should have to wait and watch for the spontaneous dilatation. While in the second stage, then again wait and watch for the spontaneous delivery, and to prevent the perineal injuries, as there is a risk in the face presentation, there is a risk of perineal injuries. So to prevent the perineal injuries, mediolateral episiotomy should be done. Episiotomy is a surgical procedure in which the cut is made on the perineum so that the fetus can easily pass through the birth canal. So mediolateral cut should be given like this, starting from the mid, then towards the side. This is a mediolateral episiotomy. While in this case, in the mento posterior position, in the first stage, wait and watch for the spontaneous dilatation, and if the dilatation occurs, and in the next stage, if the dilatation occur, then watch for the second stage so that the spontaneous delivery can occur. So if in the second stage, if the chin is rotates 3/8 of the circle, then wait for the spontaneous file on the other hand side. So here, while on the other hand side, if there is a mal rotation, no rotation, mal rotation, or arrest occurs, in that case, manual rotation should be done, because due to the weak uterine contractions or due to any other factor, there is no rotation or mal rotation. In that case, manual rotation should be done, means the chin should be rotated with the hands, that is known as manual rotation procedure, or forceps delivery should be done. Or cesarean section. That's all about the face presentation. Guys, if you find my videos useful, then please share it with other students too. So at last, stay safe, stay at home. Thank you.